Reproduction in plants. Reproduction and vegetative propagation. Reproduction. You know that reproduction is one of the characteristics of living things. All living things grow old and die. So it is necessary for them to make more organisms to keep the species going. So reproduction is important. Plants are living things, so plants have to reproduce too. You have studied about the basic different parts of a plant. You know that a plant has roots, stems, and leaves. As the plant grows older, it bears flowers and fruit. You know that reproductive organs of the plant are in the flower. The flower turns into the fruit and the fruit has seeds. New plants grow from the seeds. But this does not happen for all plants. There are many plants which do not reproduce this way. Plants that bear fruits have seeds. But what about plants like sugarcane and potato? Have you even seen the seeds of the rose plant? No, because there aren't any. But these plants still reproduce. That means there are many other ways in which plants reproduce too. We know for sure that some plants can reproduce even without seeds. Plants that reproduce with seeds are said to be into sexual reproduction. Plants that reproduce without seeds are said to be into asexual reproduction. We'll be taking a look at some ways of asexual reproduction now. Vegetative propagation. Propagation means going ahead. Vegetative parts of the plant are the root, stem, leaves, etc. So reproduction that happens through the parts of the plant such as root, stem, leaves, etc. is called vegetative propagation. Rose and champa reproduce this way. You can cut a branch of the rose plant and bury the cutting in the soil. When you cut out the branch, you have to make sure you include at least one node in it. A node is a part of the stem from which a branch or leaf grows. This is a node. Stick the cutting in the soil and keep the soil moist by watering around it. In a few months, you will see that this cutting develops its own root and starts new leaf growth too. So, it becomes a new plant. Note that for a rose, this happens best when the temperature is not too hot and not too cold. But you got a whole new plant from a part of the stem. That is vegetative propagation. What about a potato? If you take a fresh potato and look at it, you can see the eyes of the potato. What are these eyes? They are actually nodes. The potato that we eat is the stem of the potato plant. It is an underground stem. If you cut out a part of the potato with the eyes in it and plant it in the soil and water it regularly, after some days, you will see new roots and leaves sprouting out from it. This is another example of vegetative propagation. Ginger and turmeric also grow this way. A plant called bryophyllum reproduces through its leaves. It grows small buds on the edge of its leaves. When any leaf falls to the ground, a new plant can grow from each bud. In some plants, a new plant can grow from the root. Sweet potato and dahlia are such plants. So, we have seen how reproduction happens through the stem, leaves, or roots. This is vegetative propagation. Plants that reproduce this way can do it much faster than the ones that reproduce through seeds. In vegetative propagation, since there is only one parent, the child is an exact copy of the parent. What did we just learn? Reproduction is necessary for all living things to keep the species alive. Some plants reproduce through seeds. This is called sexual reproduction. Some plants reproduce without seeds. This is called asexual reproduction. Vegetative propagation is a type of asexual reproduction. In vegetative propagation, new plants are produced from the different vegetative parts of the plant, such as roots, stems, leaves, etc.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.